Hello everyone and welcome to Dress My Craft. This is design team member Jayashree this side. Today I will be sharing a process tutorial on how to make two different cards using one paper pad. Before we dive into the tutorial, do subscribe to our channel if you haven't already and hit the bell icon to never miss any video from us again. To make the cards, I will be using the Nesting Circles die from Dress My Craft. It has a total of 10 different sizes of circle dies ranging from 5 inch to 6.75 inch. I will be using the Magnolias pattern paper pack from Dress My Craft to make my cards. This pattern paper has 12 designs with 2 sheets each and comes in 2 sizes, 12 by 12 inches and 6 by 6 inches. It has beautiful magnolia floral theme going all along the pattern papers, with some feathers, beautiful floral dream catchers and much more. This pattern paper has beautiful shades of pink, greens and blues along with some vintage shades of browns as well. The DMC pattern papers also come with an extra inch on top which can be trimmed away and used later on as layers. It also has last design with some sentiments and note cards which can be cut apart and used as inserts. For my card base, I am using DMC's 250 GSM off-white card stock which is perfect for card making, scrapbooking and much more. I have cut a 12 by 12 card stock in half and then scored both the pieces at 6 inches to make two top fold square cards. Now I will take fourth circle die from top and leaving just 1/16 of an inch space from top, I will cut the cards into two circles. I have also cut two different pattern papers from the same size circle die as my base paper layers, which as you can see are full circles. Now I am taking sixth die from the top and placing it inside our previous die to form a circular border of approximately half an inch. I am placing both of them on selected pattern paper and adhering it in their places using washi tape temporarily so that the dies don't move while die cutting. I am going to cut two pieces of this border for both my cards. Now taking the leftover circle of the pattern paper, I will cut a smaller circular border using the innermost die and the third die from the center. I am cutting only one piece of the same cardstock. Also, as you would have noticed, I have speeded up the video in order to save time. Since I will be making two cards, one of them will be a double shaker card and one a mixed media layered card. So, to begin with the shaker card, I have cut an acetate sheet from DMC in the same size as my card base. To adhere it on the back of my bigger circular border, I am using 6mm red tacky tape. I will apply this all around both the circle borders. Now, taking a bone folder from DMC, I will burnish it properly so as to remove all air bubbles. I am removing the backing of the tape and adhering the acetate sheet on it by carefully aligning the circles and burnishing it very well. I have also applied the same red tacky tape on the smaller circular border which I am adhering in the center on the acetate sheet. Next, to create the depth for the shaker elements, I am using 6mm 3D foam tape from DMC and adhering it all around the acetate sheet on the back. I will add two layers of it on both the outside circular border as well as the inside one. Make sure that your foam tape is not visible through the acetate sheet and you are placing it within the white circular border. Now, to add interest on my base pattern paper, I will cut out the feathers elements from the Magnolias Motif Sheets pack. This pack has two sheets full of various elements matching the pattern paper. I am adhering the feathers in the center using 4mm 3D foam tape from DMC. This will give us a very nice effect of a dream catcher. Now it's time to add the shaker elements. I'm using the DMC sequences in the color Shabby Chic and Hug Me, along with some micro pearl beads. I'm adhering some sequences in the background so that not all the shaker elements fall when the card is kept upright. DMC has a wide variety of sequences and flower pearls. To know more about them, check out our previous video, the link to which is given in the description box below. Now I am adding the Shabby Chic colored sequence in the center and Hug Me colored sequence in the outer circle. The links to all the products used in this tutorial are given in the description box below, so do check that out. I am also adhering some sequences in the base of the outer circle's top. Now finally adding some micro pearl beads in both inside and outside circle, I will remove the tape backing and adhere the base pattern paper on top of it. Here our shaker card is ready. I am adhering it to the card base using a liquid adhesive. Now it's time to add some embellishments on top to finish our card. For this, I have die cut a doily using classic doily die and leaves from Hugs and Kisses die set from DMC. I also have a chipboard sentiment which says best wishes, a flower bunch with pollens and rose buds, and a 45mm pink flower. I have also made a bow using DMC's white satin cord. I am simply using my hot glue gun to assemble them together. Here is the final look of the card. Moving on to the next card, I am distressing the other circular border I had cut before. I am using Tim Holtz paper distressing tool. I am next inking the edges using distress oxide in the color walnut stain. I am adhering it on top of my base pattern paper. Now to embellish this card, I am using yellow vintage lace from DMC. I am making some frills while adhering it using hot glue. Next, I have die cut these leaves using the same pattern paper and DMC's leaves and foliage die set. I also have a doily die cut out from DMC's classic doily die. I have fussy cut out floral element and a couple of feathers from Magnolia motif sheet, a butterfly fussy cut out from Dots and Stripes motif sheet, and some leaves fussy cut out from Teeny Weenie's motif sheet. I am also using a 45mm blue rose flower. I am starting by adhering the doily die cut, over which I am adding some gouache to add layer and more interest. I am now just arranging all the elements to see which fits where better. While I arrange my elements, why don't you hit the like button and share some love with us. Here I have cut a small piece of border from the motif sheet and using DMC's banner punch, I am simply punching one end of it. I am trimming off the other end to fit it on my card. Now I am adhering all my elements as per the arrangement. I am starting by adding the fussy cut out magnolia flower bush, gouged with the rose flower on top of it. I am adding the fussy cut out leaves using the 4mm 3D foam tape along with the feathers tucked under the flower. The leaves die cutouts on the either side of the flower along with some chipboard leaves. Next, I am adhering the fussy cutout butterfly on the right side. Lastly, I am adding a sentiment strip on top of the banner cut before and adhering the banner on the card using 12mm 3D foam tape from DMC. Now using the same foam tape, I am adhering this base layer on top of my card base. To add final touches, I am adding some sequins in the color Shabby Chic and water droplets in the size number 3 here and there on the card. Lastly, I am adding a bow on the left side made using green satin cord from DMC. Here is the final look of the card. I hope you liked this tutorial and are inspired to make your own cards using Magnolia's pattern paper. Don't forget to like and share this video and hit the subscribe button along with the bell icon to never miss a video from us again. Until next time, happy crafting. Bye-bye.